January 12, 1990. He was 6 pounds 9 ounces. He was red when he was a baby boy. He was long. My daughter Latricia used to call him Baby Jesus. Why? I don't know.
I remember when he was a little boy. He was handsome. He always had a fat, chubby face but a little body. And he used to get nothing but toys. He was real spoiled. And my mom used to take him everywhere, like she couldn't leave him with nobody else.
Well, she was like a whiner. I guess because he was the first boy in the family for a while, and he was just spoiled rotten. I think 2 years later, I had another son, was Steven, and Rashid was the older brother. He still was spoiled. Rashid was clean, didn't want to get dirty, didn't want to play, you know, the other boys was like to play rough house or whatever. Rashid, nah, he ain't want to get his white pants dirty, didn't want to get his hands dirty. He used to always say to him, "Wait, when you grow up, you're going to be like, can we all just get along?" Never wanted to fight no way, never wanted to have no competition with anybody.
I remember one time, I got into this confrontation with this, it was in elementary school with this boy, and Alvin knew him, but I didn't know him. So like after we fought, Alvin told him like that was my brother, and like after that, it was no more problems. But like he always came to my rescue.
When I first met Alvin Way, my first impression on him was that he was a mellow type of guy. He stayed to himself, kind of. He was quiet. He didn't really bother nobody. He was cool to be around with. And we got even, like, we got more to be friends. Him and his brothers was in after school programs with me and my brothers. We all chilled. We had fun. Going after school, I looked forward with it. Like, every day after school, I looked forward to going after school programs, knowing that he was there. And when he wasn't there, it wasn't the same. Like, because he made it fun.
Alvin Way was my big cousin. And man, we was real cool. We used to go to school together, do a little bit of everything together.
It was always us three with my mom. We always used to go out together, like amusement parks and stuff like that.
He graduated from eighth grade. He had got so many awards. When they was calling him up on the stage, Alvin Way, Alvin Way, I was so proud. I was just like ecstatic. I was so happy. Tears just rolled down my eyes. I just kept clapping. And he was carrying a flag because he was the tallest guy. So he carried the flag on graduation day.
Our eighth grade graduation was the best because when I first got there, I was kind of late, but he was the first one at the door and he was the first one that gave me a compliment, which made me feel better. Like, because I thought I was overdressed because everybody had your everyday outfits on. I was the only one with a graduation dress on. So he gave me a compliment and I stayed with him like the whole day. We took pictures, it was fun. Like I didn't want to leave. I wanted him to like go with me and my family to dinner and stuff. We took pictures. I had real fun with them.
And I was proud when he got his first job at Philly and Hilly paint store, getting paid every week. And he was only going to the ninth grade then. That was his first summer job. When I got married, he gave me away. He had so much fun. He was dancing. He was just dancing with people, smiling. He was all happy and joy. And he stood there proudly. And when the pastor asked who gave them away, give his mother away, he was like, "We do, because him and my other son gave me away."
Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning. Alvin was a student in my English 4 class. I had known him for a couple years before that, but it wasn't until this past September that I actually met him and he became a student in my class. Overall, he was just very respectful. He always, anytime the class, if they ever started to get out of hand, he would help calm them down, say, yo, let's come on, we gotta get to work, and he would always calm them down, and they would listen to him, so he was a leader in the class. But he still was able to laugh, and he even laughed at my corny jokes sometimes, a few times I made them. So he was a good guy, definitely.
Alvin was really imaginative, so when he would always come up with these crazy ideas, which was unusual for a high school kid, because a lot of high school kids seem to want to do everything realistic. But he would do, he did stuff like, he would draw the space between things, and he would turn things into like aliens. He did like really cool, interesting stuff. Even like his sense of humor was like that too. He's really, imaginative. He was like nice to everybody in the room. Like he didn't leave anybody out. He would like, even like the kids, you know, that would sit like be real quiet, he would always like, you know, start messing with them. Like he made everybody like come out of their shell, you know. He was really funny that way. He would always keep the sharpener on his desk. It was like his personal sharpener. I'd be looking all over for it, and then there was on his desk all the time. So, and then he dropped it, and I got mad at him.
Other people have said this, but he did have probably the strongest handshake I've ever encountered in my life, which is a sign of maturity, a sign of confidence, a sign of respect. He always went out of his way to help people. Students aren't really, I never say they're a grown up till they graduate. He was one of the few students who I would say was a grown up while still a student in high school.
I met Alvin during his freshman year here at Furness. He was part of the Variety Club program, and Mr. Chisholm introduced me to him and then passed him periodically in the halls, and just knew of him to be a very friendly, kind student. In the summer of 2006, my son David had passed away, and we had 934 students enrolled at that time, and there was one student that came to my son's viewing, and it was Alvin. So it meant a lot to me that he was there. When we came back to school in the September, he made it a point every day to stop in and just see how he was doing. Sometimes just to give me a hug, and you know, there were no words necessary, just to support. Really touched me and meant a lot to me. And it was during one of those visits that we started to talk about the donor dash. Our family had attended the year previous. There were 24 of us, I think, that went the first year. And I asked Alvin if he thought some of the students might want to join, and he said, absolutely. He said, I'd like to run, and I'll get some of the other students. And he did just that. He ran the 5K in, I think, 32 minutes, did well, and was instrumental in getting other students to come. And so this year, in the beginning of the school year in September, we were offered to apply for a Donors or Heroes grant through the Gift of Life, and we did, and I selected 8 senior students to kind of chair this team, and Alvin was one of those students, and he attended the summits at the Gift of Life, and was very instrumental in creating the programs here at the school, the numerous programs that we held, and they were very successful, and Alvin was a part of all of that. And as you know, he joined us this year and passed away at the finish line.
Yeah, we was close cousins. Like, we did a little bit of everything. Go to school in the morning, go at the school with each other. We used to go to the library. We did everything. Get on the 17 bus, go to his house, go meet up with his little brothers, have fun with his mom and his dad, everything. We did everything together. I was like my favorite big cousin.
We went to the library together. That's what he liked to do.
Like, we used to always talk. Anytime we went to the computer lab, he sat next to me, and we used to just talk about everything, like life. I don't know, just like the simplest things we talked about that made it so fun, like made it deep. A really firm relationship with him, I guess.
Like, I wanted to be like him because everybody liked him. He had that attitude, like he could get along with everybody. And I'm not like that at all. But I just wanted to be like that. Like, he was a role model. He loved everyone. even if you hated him, he still loved you. Like, not in a love, like, hug, but he never hated anyone. He always thought that hate was a bad word. Like, if he disliked you, he didn't even dislike you. He had love for everybody.
That was like my role model. Like, he was going to college. He had a lot of respect. Like, he was the man. Told me to go to college. He told me to do a little bit of everything. Well, yeah, when I was about to fight somebody, and he kept grabbing me, like, telling me to calm down. Don't go at him, man. He's just a little kid. Like, you ain't gotta do that. Like, you ain't gonna graduate. That's what he, and I looked up to that, and I followed what he told me. Then the next couple of days, he was gone. I was like, dang. I'm glad I listened to him, because he saved me. He helped me out with my projects and all that. Man, he did everything. I can't do it. Can't do that part. That part killing me. The good moments.
He was very caring. Always liked to share. He always say, sharing is caring. He was determined, never gave up on anything. Always willing to help a person, always wanted a job so he could, have his own money in his pocket.
What I remember about Rashid is he was just a caring person. He was always thoughtful. He would give you his last if he had it. He was the go-to person. If I needed help with anything on a computer, I would always ask him. He never turn me down or tell me it's something, so he always was thinking of others first. When I was looking for a job and I asked him, can I go to a Master Pet where he was working at? And I had just got laid off from being an administrative assistant. And I was like, is they hiring? And he was like, yeah, I'll get you an application. I was like, I don't wanna do cash register work. And I was, acting uppity. And he was like, well, Trisha, you have to start somewhere. Maybe you'll be in a fish aisle with me. You just have to start somewhere. Maybe you could be on cash register. And I just thought that was so sweet that he thought of me like that.
I think Alvin left a legacy of kindness and demonstrated his commitment in supporting not only me, our family, and everyone that was involved with organ donation. He absolutely demonstrated that to go the extra mile and to help each other in whatever way students can do it. He absolutely demonstrated that.
I learned that life is short, no matter how old you are. So live it like every day as you could, making good memories of it. Take life serious. And one thing I'm gonna miss is the conversation we used to have, his greeting and his crazy behind laugh. He used to always, it was funny though, but I would miss a lot about him though. Alvin is someone you can't forget, no matter like if you try to. You're not gonna forget about him.
I'll remember him as being a really special person. Just like, he made everybody feel really good about, everything. I mean, he made everything fun. He just was a really joyful person to be around. So that's how I'll remember him.
Class of 2009 has had its issues throughout the school year as their senior year started. They've had some problems, some ups and downs. When he passed, he brought all of them together in a way that I haven't seen in years. So that just shows how powerful his presence was while he was here, and even more so after he's gone. So he definitely won't be forgotten by any of us, including me.
I have to say, and through all of this, and I've learned through my own son's passing that, you never miss up an opportunity to say the things you feel for people and just let them know. And when I think back on it, I mean, every time I was in his company privately or here in the counseling suite, whenever I would see him, I would just give him a hug and say, I love you. And he would say the same back. So I'm grateful that I have that as a memory. and that I, you know, took the time to share that.
I listen to him every day. I still be seeing it. They ain't here. That's crazy.
I'm gonna miss my brother so much. It's not a day go by that I don't think of him. And I know he in a better place just watching over us.
If I could give him times, turn back the times of the hands of a clock, I wish that I had that moment, like, just to hug him one more time. Now that's something that we always have done anyway. Every day before he leave out this house, he always say, "Mom, I love you," and I always say, "Have a good day," and he'll kiss me on my forehead every single day. Even when he called and I'm not in the house, he say, "Mom, I'm home from school," and I was like, "All right, how was your day?" He'll say, "Fine." I say, "Okay, I'll be home." You know, he's like, "I love you." We always said that every single day, and always gave me a kiss on the forehead. And the last thing I can remember him coming in my room on April the 19th, 2 hours before he passed, he said to me, "Mom, you gonna take me to the donor's awareness one?" And I said, gave him an eye to ask my husband. And he said, "Gat, you gonna take me?" Gat was like, "Man," he's like, "Come on." And so Gat got up to take him. I just wish that I was in that car with him so I'd give him a one last hug, a big hug, and a kiss. I miss my son so much.
This is Rashid Way. And his other grandmother's name is also Marie, Alvin's mother. Her name is Marie, Marie Way. She is the grandmother. Of these four beautiful children.